Oh my fucking law. Physics journal day. See ya. Physics journal. That's pronounced journal. I'm sorry. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. This one right here got requested and there's a 2018 involved, so that kind of looks like something from MIT Integration B or something. But we are still going to give it a shot. It's actually quite easy, to be honest. The guy who sent me this was confused by those absolute values right here, and he didn't really know what to do. So at first, I would love to introduce a little substitution. This argument right here. So let t be equal to 2018 times x. That also means that dt is nothing but 2018 times dx. We can divide both sides by 2018 because it's not equal to zero, hopefully. And now we can plug all of this new stuff in. So for the upper and lower bounds, the new ones, we have on the one hand, well, if we plug x equals to zero into here, well, this is just going to be zero. And if we plug 2018 times pi into here, this is going to be a 2018 squared times pi. And also we have the absolute value of sine of t in this case, and dt over 2018. And you can also do it without the substitution. I just want to make the thought process clear on how to solve this integral. Okay, we can bring this one over something to the outside. But at first, I would like to take a look at the graph of this thing right here. So, you know, if we just take a look at the normal sine wave, you could say we have something like this right here. And if you do some analysis, some calculations, you might notice that this bump right here has basically the same area as this bump right here. Just this one has a negative sign when it comes to this. So if you integrate from 0 to 2 pi, in this case, you are going to end up with 0 because those two would nullify each other. But now we are going to take a look at the absolute value of sine of t. And you see the absolute value does nothing but change all the negative values into positive values. So every time we have a bump down here in the negative y zone, you could say, it just gets swapped around. You know, so it goes up here. I hope you can see where this came from. So our new sinusoidal wave would look like this right here. And nothing has changed when it comes to the area right here. Just the sign is going to be the same one right here. So this has a certain area, this has the same area, this has the same area, and so on. It's nice and periodic. Nothing would really change. So now we have talked about this, and now I just want to split this thing up right here a little bit. So you know, this is nothing but, let's bring this constant to the outside, 1 over 2018. And now we have a first interval going from 0 to pi. And now we have absolute value, sine of t, dt. And now we have a second one, plus integral from, well, from pi to 2 pi. Absolute value, sine of t, dt, plus, and so on. This list goes on and on until integral from, so the upper bound is 2018 squared times pi, and down here we just have 2018 squared minus 1 times pi, absolute value of sine of t dt. And by our argumentation before, this right here has the same area as this one, this one, blah, 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 until this one. And we have those integrals right here, 2018 squared times. So those right here exist 2018 squared times. So all that's really left to do is to calculate the area under the curve of that thing and, well, just multiply it by 2018 squared and also by the reciprocal of this thing right here. And then we are basically done. So what exactly is the integral from 0 to pi of absolute value sine of t dt? Well, that's really easy, to be honest, because on this interval, our sine only takes positive y values. So that also means that the absolute value of this thing is just the thing itself. So this is nothing but the integral from 0 to pi of sine of t dt. And well, we know how to integrate that. This is nothing but the negative cosine. It should be the negative cosine. So this is the negative cosine of t from 0 to pi. And well, this is nothing but, okay, so this is going, no, it's the positive cosine. I got confused right now. So we have cosine of pi. No, it's the negative cosine. I'm fucking stupid, seriously. So we have the negative cosine of pi. This is going to be 1 just. And the negative cosine of 0 is just negative 1. But we have the second part of the integration, negative 1. So we have 1 plus 1 overall. This is 2. And now the final value for our integral is nothing but. So we have 1 over 2018. Then we have 2 times 2018 squared. This and that is going to cancel out. We end up with 2018 times 2. And this is nothing but 4036. And that's how you integrate something like this. You can also do this by using proper estimations, approximations, inequalities, stuff like this. But that's basically it. I hope you did enjoy this video. I'm terribly sorry for this little part. Sometimes I confuse the antiderivatives and derivatives of those trigonometric functions. I hope you can excuse me for this. I love you guys. Appreciate you. Please share those videos everywhere. It helps the channel grow. If you want to support the channel a bit more by my stupid ass t-shirts I created, or support me on Patreon or something. And up until the next video, however, let's go back to the good old times. Oh my fucking lord. Physics Journal Day. See ya. Physics Journal. That's pronounced journal. I'm sorry.